I think this light head is probably about 28 feet from me, and it feels like the sun. Like, it actually looks like the sun. It feels exactly like the sun. It feels like I've brought the sun into my studio space, and then I'm cheating it. I feel like I'm cheating. Like, I shouldn't be able to cheat like this, but that's what the PB70, a Lightstream, allows you to do. This little thing is called the PB70. It's Dedolight's 1.2K 2-degree beamer. That's what it does. That's what it's built to do. A long ways away from a little classic 150-watt Dedolight, but it is still a Dedolight. You have a homogeneous 2-degree beam that you can send far distances, just like you would hope a xenon light would work, but this one can be plugged into a standard household socket. Yes, that's true. You do not need a generator for this, depending on how many you have. Of course, you may have to do that, but as a standalone light head that you can reimagine using reflectors, yes, this one can be plugged into, as Ditta would say, grandma's kitchen. The parabolic reflector is built to have a unique symbiotic relationship with the lamp itself. That is how it gives you a 2-degree, 70-centimeter beam, ergo the title, PB70. Just like you would use a small little Dedolight in order to pinpoint your light source and really carve out light, this one is like threading a needle with a very hot, intense beam. You can create multiple sources of light by splitting this large 70-centimeter beam, ergo the name PB70, into different locations to create new light sources. The reflector of the PB70 has a unique relationship with the lamp. It creates a really hot 2-degree beam. Really, the light was realized in order to create new light with reflectors. Now, in order for those reflectors to work well and to actually take full advantage of them, you need a hot parallel light source. This light creates almost a virtual light source, a light source that feels like it's coming from maybe 40 feet behind the actual light. So when you have something like this, you can actually start stretching your shadows, collapsing the amount of space that you would need to actually have what looks like realistic sunlight. But if you're using it to bounce off of reflectors, well, that's a completely different situation, isn't it? Because now I could actually start my light here, keep it on the ground, keep it in the box, tilt it in any direction that I want, turn it on and put it into a reflector and collapse the amount of space that I need in order to get a hot beam of sunlight coming through a window. I'm gonna let this thing come up a little bit here. Now, I'm probably 15 feet away from my number one reflector over here. That's a 1 by 1 meter reflector. And I'm gonna mosey my way over to my set here. And as that comes up, and it's gonna be super bright because I'm very close to it in this particular setup inside this little studio. But guess what? In order to get this to actually work within this studio, I would have to go across the street and get a permit and get a condor and put that thing up in the sky, probably about 30 feet to get the same type of look that I'm doing here. Except that I have the light head right in front of me and I'm just reflecting it in order to collapse the amount of space that I need to do it. Now the PB70 is a magical light.